What up? Welcome back in. Shout out as always, Tribal San Diego, always representing. Start this one off with the old Coors Banquet. It's time to talk about a new bike, but it's not mine. Don't worry. All right, so I just finished building up this Yeti SB160. So this is not my bike. One of my good friends came to me and said, Dustin, I just bought myself a Yeti SB160. What's up, Cruz? Cruz is just gonna hang out for this video. He's like, hey man, I just bought a Yeti SB160. My buddy, shout out Florian, he's really big into XC. He's done a lot of races in the last couple of years. He went and did the Swiss Epic. He slayed on that thing. He has a Specialized Epic Evo. Things like 22 pounds, if that. Just a total Slayer XC machine. And he's like, hey, I want to come ride some park with you and your buddies. And he has been really eyeballing this new SB160. And I think this would be the perfect bike for him. The perfect bike to complement his Epic Evo 160, 170 travel, just absolute trail slayer, smash wagon, whatever you want to call it. This bike is sick. I'm super, super impressed with this thing and how well it turned out. So he just came to me and said, let's build an absolute destroyer of a weapon going downhill. And here it is, man. So SB160 frame, so large. It is the Turk, of course. You can't get anything but Turk. If you're going Yeti, in my opinion, and your first one, it's always got to be turquoise. That color is so sick. So I'm gonna start right here, right in the center. Got a Float X2, but we are gonna be running a Super Deluxe coil shock. This is the new Super Deluxe Ultimate. I'm just waiting on the mounting hardware for this thing. Boom. This is the new one. This is the same one that I run on my Score 4060. We did get the spring right here. I believe this is a 450. Perfect for his weight. But he did want to... When you got a bike that's 21 pounds, you can kind of make your big bike just do whatever you want. And I said, do a coil, man. Absolute traction factory. I think he's going to be super stoked with that. Brings me up to the front. 170 RockShox Zeb Ultimate. This is the new one with the buttercups. The new RockShox stuff is so unbelievably good. I can only imagine what this fork's gonna feel like. If it feels, I have the Lyric on my 4060, and that thing has been the best fork I've ever had. So I'm really happy we went with the Zeb Ultimate on this bike with the buttercups. Let's talk about front end here. NV bar, the NV M7 bar with the NV alloy 35 mil stem. Grips, these are the Trail 1 Hell's Gate grips. I'm a big fan of these grips. Shout out to the guys at Worldwide, Liam and Jeff. I really like those guys, and I really feel like they're as passionate about mountain biking as I am. And these grips are home run. Brake-wise, I've been running the Magura MT7s on my Score. Florian does have the Magura trail brakes on his lightweight bike, so it was kind of a no-brainer. Boom, MT7. These are the HC3s. These have that fully adjustable lever. These levers are so sick. These brakes have been the best brakes I've ever rode. I've been on the Codes. I've been on the Shimano XTs, I've been on the Formula Curas, and I haven't tried the TRPs yet, but these are far and away my favorite. Zero brake fade, bleeds up, super, the bleed on these is just unbelievably easy. They feel super sharp and snappy, tons of modulation, but once you get through that thing and you get your finger in there, there is just power for days. Attached to the end of these brakes, Storm HC rotors. We got the 203 in the front, 180 in the rear, ample stopping power there, more than enough in my opinion. Wheels, These are the NV M730s. So these are a 32 spoke bladed Supeme, CX Rays, 2 Cross. They do have the rim strip, the NV rim strip, which is pretty nice. So basically, it alleviates any of the rim tape, which how many times have you been pulling your tire off and you put the tire lever in there and scuff your rim tape and boom, now you've got a hole in it and it doesn't hold air and now you gotta retape your wheels, which is always a pain in the butt. These things are killer, and not only does it make just putting the tire on so much easier, there's they claim, not their words, not mine, it just completely eliminates flats altogether. I'm assuming that doesn't mean like puncture flats, but like pinch flats, no more. So, bold claims there from Envy, but yeah, I don't know. I believe them. Wrapped on these Envy wheels is Max's tires. I mean, this point, I'm just not gonna recommend anything else or not gonna ride anything else. Ask a guy 2.5 in the front. Max Terra EXO, a little bit heavier casing on this, just a touch. Being that this is just a big smash wagon, why not have a little extra protection? DHR2 2.4 in the rear. Max Terra EXO Plus. Nice fast rolling rubber compound on those. So even though it is a little bit beefier tire, you're not really going to sacrifice a ton of rolling resistance or rolling speed with the Max Terra compound. You know, if you really want to get crazy with it, throw a max grip, ask a guy on the front. If you're just, you know, going to Silver Mountain, somewhere big like that, that's what I would do. But I felt like this was a more appropriate choice because he does still like to pedal his bikes, and I want to keep him pretty fast rolling on the way to the top and have just ample traction on the way down. So that was the tire spec on that guy. This thing was super easy to build, especially with all the electronic stuff. Access post 170 with an Ergon Enduro saddle. My favorite saddle out there right now. This thing is killer. With the oil slick rails, but yeah, super comfortable saddle. 170 travel on the dropper post. Running the new transmission. The new transmission. If you guys didn't catch it, I did a little video on that talking about my thoughts on it, and I'm absolutely blown away. I think it is far and away the best. I mean, there's nothing even close, in my opinion. Went XO on this bike, 32 chainring in the front, got some bash guards on there. XO, everything in the back. And what's crazy is the XO is only, even with the aluminum cranks, it's only like 150 grams heavier than the XX, which I run on my bike. Especially on a bike like this, that you're gonna be riding at the bike park and smashing into stuff. Last thing you wanna worry about is snapping a crank or, you know, chipping or cracking a carbon crank. I've never done it before, but hey, you never know. In my opinion, better to go with the alloy cranks, especially on a bike like this. XT Trail pedals, clipless. That's what he normally rides. That's what I ride. You can beat the hell out of them. You never have to maintain them and basically just set and forget. So, yeah, there it is. That's the bike check Yeti SB160. It is a large, so I might try and sweet talk him into let me take this thing for a spin. I think it does kind of, it's slightly on the bigger side for me. I'm about 5'10. I think he's right around 6 foot. So I think that's going to be perfect for him. But yeah, I just thought that I'd take this opportunity since I just finished building this bike up to kind of show you guys Florian's new trail weapon. This thing's gonna be an absolute slayer. We're going to Bellingham here in 2 weeks, and this is gonna be the perfect bike for this bike trip. I'm taking my score. Got all the coil stuff on there and some grippy tires, and we're gonna go give it hell. So, hey. Thanks for tuning in. I appreciate all you guys have been sticking around. I know I'm kind of all over the board with my motorcycles and my drums and stuff, so I'm gonna do my best to kind of keep everybody happy here. And I hope you guys enjoy this. And like I said, I always appreciate you guys. Thanks for everyone that's sticking around. We'll catch you on the next one and see where we go from here. But I'm definitely gonna be doing a video on our trip to Bellingham. And I'm going to bring you guys along. We're going to do a little video about that as well. So stay tuned for that. Again, thanks everybody for sticking around. And we'll catch you on the next one. Me and Cruz out. Peace.